Hey, hello, I'm Yolo. Let's continue our work on texturing. Okay, we will start with her yellow dress. I'm creating a new folder and duplicating the base layer there. Since I love all the existing lighting settings and I just want to change the color. I'm adding a paint sublayer to the folder's black mask, and with the polygon fill tool, I'm selecting only dress polygons in the UV view. And now I'm just changing colors and tweaking settings a bit. Moving on, I'm adding another folder for the dark lines on her dress, duplicating the base layer from the dress folder and adding a black mask with a paint sublayer. But since the colors of the base layer are exactly the same as for the dress, I'm adding a temporary gray fill layer just to see where my lines will be. And now I'm very roughly painting them. I'm adding another paint sublayer before refining those draft lines. The top sublayer will contain a black mask for everything except her dress, so that I don't have to worry about my lines going beyond the border of the dress. And finally, I'm refining lines. And I'm also adding her boots to the main folder mask. Now it's finally time to change the color of the lines. I want to add more light, so I'm adding a baked lighting material and setting it to linear dodge. As you can see, my actions are repeated over and over again in the same pattern. This is because I try not to overcomplicate the texturing process. So I'm afraid I will be repeating myself a lot today. I'm also adding a baked lighting material into the hair folder. I'm changing the sun color a bit, playing with roughness and other sliders. Next, I'm adding a white mask with a paint sublayer to mask out some of the parts I don't really like. And finally, I want to make the light softer with a blur filter. The next in line is her antennas. Let's create a folder and duplicate a base layer for them. I'm changing colors to something darker, tweaking settings and adding a baked lighting material too. I added two filters to my lighting material. Blur filter to make light a bit softer and levels to adjust contrast slightly. And as you can see, I can't work without my masks. So I'm adding a white mask and removing light from some parts. I didn't really like the result, so I continued to work on the lighting material and move different sliders. My baked lighting material only has one light source, the sun, so to eliminate the character from behind, I duplicate this material and rotate the sun. For the final touch, let's add a fill layer, black mask and a linear gradient to it. And don't forget to change the fill layer color from gray to something better. And now, to the most exciting part of this video. Let's work on her face. First of all, I want to add color variety to her face. To do so, I'm adding a pink fill layer with a black mask and a paint sublayer, as usual. Adding some red color to her cheeks, nose and lips, and then reducing the layer opacity. Now let's add another fill layer with a darker color for the shadows on her face. The process is exactly the same, but we will add a fill sublayer to the black mask this time. And we will use our AO texture in that fill sublayer. But it needs to be inverted, so I'm adding levels on top of that and pressing the invert button. I'm tweaking level sliders and fill color. And finally, let's add a paint sublayer and hide the shadows under her eyes. I'm adding another fill layer with a mask to add a tiny portion of red color. And now I'm adding a paint layer to overpaint her face. I do this to give the texture a more hand-painted look. I'm cleaning those very dark shadows and working on her nose. Cleaning up shadows. When I paint, I try to think about it similar to sculpting. By adding light or shadows, I change the visual shape of the object. I want to make shadows under her chin a bit lighter. So I decided to add one more baked lighting material and a fill layer with pink color to add it to her lips. And back to overpainting the model. Note that it's very important to carefully work on the surface of the eyelids in the UV view. If you leave some graphic artifacts there, they will certainly become visible when character will be blinking. And it can really ruin all your hard work. I love freckles, and I think they can make any girl cuter, so let's add them to our B character too. The process is the same, fill layer, mask and a paint sublayer. Thank you. The final touch will be a color correction layer. To do that, you need to add the usual paint layer, but change its blending type to pass through. And now we can add filters to it. I'm adding a hue filter and moving sliders to make the character a bit more saturated and lively. And we still need to work on her mouth cavity. So I'm adding a paint layer and painting in the UV view. And don't forget to gently paint over the space between her lips. This is it for today. Thank you for watching and see you very soon. Bye bye!